romance? I was right.
About what?
Saint Denis.
How so?
It ain't romantic. It's evil.
So, Arthur, you get the deciding vote.
About what? We take an insult and scurry off like cockroaches? Or deal with business the right way?
We don't need to take revenge. We hardly know the guy.
This ain't about revenge, Hosea. Angelo Bronte don't mean shit to me. This is about the fact we are planning to rob a bank in his town. A bank that he no doubt protects. A town where his men are gunning for us. Before we do that, we need to put him out of commission.
I disagree. There's always an easier way.
There ain't no easier way. Now, I know his type. He is a vindictive little power broker who rules by fear. Now, we pull that stunt in his cesspit of a town, we're doomed. You want to leave this place? Leave this country? We need that money.
I just don't feel good, Dutch.
This is it. This is the last job that we are ever going to pull. Before the year is out, we are going to be harvesting mangoes in Tahiti. Oh. Farmers. But we need seed capital, and we need to leave. You know it. I know it.
Forgive me if I can't think too much about the mango harvest.
This is it. Trust me. Arthur.
If it's business, well, business is business.
Angelo Bronte stands between us and our future.
You'll damn us all.
Arthur, come on.
You better be right about this one.
I am.
I've heard that before, and usually I've been right. If you say so.
Quit doubting, Arthur. It does no favors. Come on. We need to go see a man about a boat.
A boat?
We're headed to a settlement called Le Gras. I met a boatman there called Thomas who knows these waters like the back of his hand.
Why do we need a boat?
So we can attack Bronte's mansion from the swamp. Catch him off guard. He knows we survived the trolley station, so he'll be expecting some kind of reprisal.
All right. Okay, makes sense.
See? I do still possess some capacity for rational thought, Arthur.
Come on, girl.
Don't let it go cold. Come along.
Okay, follow me. Yeah. Thank you.
For what?
For taking my side.
Sides.
Feels like Hosea's lost his spine.
But this move on Bronte, is it for the bank job or revenge for what happened at the trolley station?
Both. Neither. What does it matter? We need to hit that bank. And Bronte has the police and just about everything else in Saint Denis in his back pocket. He also set us up. And lest we forget, took young Jack.
I understand. We just got a lot of pots on the boil, given all the folks who's out gunning for us.
You all seem to have forgotten how money is made and what it takes to support 20 people, let alone what it takes to give 20 people a new life overseas.
With all due respect, Dutch, is this Tahiti plan really gonna work out?
You tell me, Arthur. Is it? Have some goddamn faith! I am bending over backwards to make a future for us!
I know, but...
But? When did you become so small-minded? If you'd rather we break up the family, go our separate ways, just tell me.
Of course not.
This isn't a prison camp. I am not forcing anybody to stay. So either we're in this together, working together to get out together, or we're not. There simply isn't a reality in which we do nothing and get everything.
I know. You're right. Just feels like we're on borrowed time again. I mean, the O'Driscolls found us.
Yeah. We need to move. and soon. Haven't I made that clear? I feel like I'm going in circles with all of you. Micah is the only one left with any loyalty. Anyway, here we are. Let me do the talking. Thomas, it is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Mr. Dutch.
Thomas, have you met Arthur? Arthur, Thomas is quite the boatman. He's going to help us get close to our prey. The other night, we had quite the adventure fishing for catfish. Now, my friend, can I call in that favor?
What do you need?
You know Angelo Bronte. Well, exactly. We need to make a social call. We were hoping you could row us in quietly one evening around the back of his house.
Well, if anyone can, I can.
We'll pay you for your trouble.
If you're bringing him trouble, it won't be no trouble for me.
Good.
My business partner, Jules, he's out on the skiff. I need to check with him. Plus, I need to check the traps. Would you come with me?
Of course. Arthur?
Why not?
Shouldn't take too long if we can find him.
Be lively. Mind you, there's a lot of gators. Uncommon number. Big ones.
Great.
Come now, Arthur. It'll take more than a prehistoric reptile to scare you, Shirley.
I just want to see you meet your match when it comes to an aging predator with a big mouth, Dutch.
Arthur here is something of a comedian, Thomas. More of a jester than a gunslinger.
Well, if you say so, Mr. Dutch. This way. Come on, this way. Follow me here. And stay on the high ground.
You call this ground? It feels like water to me.
Down here, we can't be too picky there, Mr. Arthur.
Got a couple of crayfish traps up ahead.
Mr. Dutch, you keep a lookout for company. Mr. Arthur, check the traps with me.
This one's empty.
All right. I got a few more set over this way. Come on.
I don't want to know what just touched my leg.
Mr. Dutch, you sure you the right fellas to be going after Angelo Bronte?
Oh, he's much more the kind of reptile I can handle.
Now stay close. Make sure you follow my line.
Oh, I fully intend to, Thomas.
You too, Mr. Arthur.
You can see why eating in swamp wading hasn't caught on as a pastime, can't you?
I love it out here. Peaceful. Nobody bothering you none. Except for the night folk sometimes.
The night folk?
Yep, some strange people around these parts. Wilder than the animals they are.
Well, this just gets better and better.
Stop where you are. That's a gator. Just stay as still as you can. All right, let's keep moving. I got another trap by that small island up here. I don't know what's taking Jules so long with that boat.
I think we are all equally keen to find him.
behind here, Mr. Arthur. This trap is stuck in the mud. It happens.
Guess something didn't want to be caught.
My gosh. So it's true.
What is?
There's been talk of a big old bull, but people talk a lot of nonsense. I guess this was... No, but only something huge could do this.
Oh. Fantastic. Let's hope it bites you first, Dutch.
Should we just keep moving? I don't really want to hang around here much longer.
All right, I suppose this can wait. Let's go. Hold up.
My God, there's no shortage of them.
Good eating.
Us or them?
Exactly. Come on.
We really should have run into Jules by now. I reckon we should split up so we can search both sides.
Okay, Arthur, since you appear so at home here, you take the right. We'll go left.
What? Just keep your eyes open.
Someone there?
You in a tree. What are you doing?
There's a monster. A monster.
You okay up there?
There's a monster.
Where?
Mastiff, it nearly ate me.
And where'd he go?
It's out there.
What?
A big gator. Biggest I ever saw. Big and nasty. Knocked me off the boat and chased me over here.
You must be Jules.
Yes.
Where is the boat?
Over there. I ran.
Okay. And, where'd this monster swim off to?
I think that way. Good luck shooting that thing. You'll need a cannon.
The skiff! It's over here! It's stuck! Got it loose. Jump.
Good man.
All right, let's get back to the dock.
Yes, please, let's go!
Oh.
Thank God.
So, who are these fellas, Thomas?
Two new friends of mine. I'll explain later.
Jules, we are very happy to have finally made your acquaintance.
I thought I was gonna be out here all night.
What you doing hiding up in the tree, boy?
This gator was huge, Thomas. Twice as big as I ever seen. Twice as angry, too.
Nonsense.
Now what?
I think we hit a tree stump.
Yeah, I thought we cleared. You're gonna need to jump in and pull us free.
Me?
Yeah, just do it. Won't take you a minute, boy. Go on.
This is a bad idea.
You'll see any giant monster long before it gets anywhere near you. You got a couple of crack gunslingers here with the guns loaded. You'll be fine.
You didn't see the thing.
Yeah, neither did you. It's just a myth, Jules. Now pull. Pull, boy!
Jules?
Too good there.
Here, take this. Try to stop the bleeding.
You're gonna be okay, son. You're gonna be okay. Just thank your old Uncle Dutch.
I heard that. There's still a lot of blood. You need to put pressure on it.
I've stopped the bleeding. I think he'll be okay if he don't get a fever.
We can bring down a fever.
A fever is the least of our worries. Look who's back.
God damn it.
Put every bullet...
Thank you.
be okay, kid. Sorry, Jules. Guess all them stories was true. Big and mad. That's unusual. Normally, the little ones angry. Big ones is lazy.
Well, I guess he never outgrew his anger. Kind of reminds me of you, Arthur.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen you squeal before, Dutch.
I weren't the one squeal.
Yeah, well, you weren't in the water with him. And this poor boy was nearly dinner. Can we get some help? Jules has been bitten.
Oh, my God.
There's a monster out here. He's been bitten, but he's alive. Just keep him warm. Feed him garlic for the infection. Thank you. Both of you. I'm at your service anytime you need.
Thank you, Thomas. Where can we find you?
You just meet me back here.
Very good.
Can one of you help me put the boat back out?
Sure. I'm gonna head back to camp and placate the irritable Miss O'Shea, who's causing more trouble. I'll collect the boys. Meet you back here, Arthur.
Mr. Arthur? Old Bronte. He's a bad man.
I know.
Killed some good folks. Hurt a lot of people.
Well, he definitely lacks a certain charm.
I'll see you soon.
You be safe. We got monsters out here.
Well,